The next point is on non-qualifying operations. So the question goes like this. Following operations taking place in a NAFTA country will not qualify a non-NAFTA product as a NAFTA product. All right. Change in end use. So what is change in end use? We actually have a good example here. Going back to 2009, where customs have been proposed with a question. We have a spent lead acid batteries under this particular HTS number. Imported in Canada under this subheading. So here is the point. In Canada, when they came into the Canada, they were so batteries. In Canada, they were classified as 8548. But then they were used up. So what do you do with them once they're used up? Well, whatever these guys do with them, probably recycle them. The classification for the used batteries is different than classification for the non-used batteries. So once the battery becomes spent, it changes to a tariff classification to 8507.10. And all this change takes place in Canada, right? So the question is, the question is, is there enough transformation, right? If we take a look at the change at the rules of origin, so we're going to go to 10220, our tariff shift rule provision. And we'll just scroll to the 8548. is available right here, and says a change to any to heading 8548 from any other heading. So heading is first four digits. Right, a change took place from this heading to this heading, right? All right, so under this tariff shift methodology, this means that the 10220 tariff shift has been met. This means that at least under the marking rules, Canada is a country of origin, so the spent batteries qualify for NAFTA. But wait. Here's what CBP, Customs and Border Protection, has said. A foreign material shall not be considered to have undergone an applicable change in tariff classification or to have met any applicable requirements merely by reason of the change in end use. And then customs goes on to say, use of the imported spent lead acid battery has changed from being a device that can store electricity and supply it when required to a device that is neither usable or of being recharged. And then they say its end use has changed. So battery remains a battery, only it's no longer usable. It is I mean, you not no longer usable for derivation electricity, maybe usable for recycling, but it's end use from providing electricity to end use of providing parts for recycling has changed. But change in end use is not a criteria, so change in end use kills this provision. So no NAFTA for this one, because it's merely a change in end use. So this is how, this is the tricky interplay between between the 102.17 section and 102.20. Because under 102.20 it may look good, right? But if the end use has changed and nothing else has changed, then it doesn't matter. So the point here, the point here being, and this is applicable in the real world as well as in the customs broker license exam, that just by looking at 102.20 and putting a check mark may not be enough. You have to know the whole regulatory text. You have to know the context. You have to see the big picture. Just looking at one particular regulation and putting a check mark is not enough. Is not enough for you to make a determination. And as the end use lead storage electric battery showed. So change use is one. Will not qualify non-NAFTA product if there is a change in end use, as we saw in the context of the battery. Dismantling or disassembly is another example that this will not do. And on this one, customs examiners have directly asked, which is considered a non-qualifying operation under NAFTA. So when you see non-qualifying, all right, section 102.18, dismantling or disassembly. So dismantling is here, right? Dilution is provided later. Testing, marking, and sorting is dilution that materially alters characteristic of the good. All right, so here the focus on the buzzword, dismantling and disassembly. So B is the correct answer choice. So another non-qualifying operation which will not change NAFTA, even if tariff shifting complies with, simple packing, repacking, or retail packaging without more than minor processing. So if you just take stuff out of the box and put it in the blister pack, it will not do. Mere dilution with the water or another substance that does not materially alter the characteristics of the material. See, materially alters the characteristic of material. So yes, you may have combination, especially in the field of chemistry, of various materials for various purposes. You may add water in order to make a dilution, not for the purposes of storage or preservation or marketing, but to make a whole different product, right? And this is the key phrase here is material. See, here is no material change, and here is material change. So mere dilution without material change will not do.